在这地。 Good morning, brothers and sisters.
Good morning. 各位弟兄姐妹早安.
Let us begin our worship service in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的灵, 开始我们今天的崇拜.
Let's still our hearts as we sing the Lord is in his temple.
让我们预备我们的心, 我们崇唱主在圣殿中.
Psalmist said, You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, and I will exalt you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever.
诗人说,你是我的神,我要称谢你。你是我的神,我要尊崇你。你们要称谢耶和华,因为他本为善,他的慈爱永远长存。
Let's all stand and come before the Lord in prayer.
请大家一同起立, 我们低头祷告。
Our dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this opportunity we can come into your house to worship you. Lord, we thank you that you are our God. You are the one who has led us. You are the one who has sustained us. You are the one who has blessed us and give us everything. Lord, we thank you that even though we are not worthy to receive all your blessings, but Lord, you have made us your children. You have bestowed upon us your favor. Lord, we pray that you will draw us nearer to you as we come before you as your children, Lord, to the Heavenly Father. May you look upon us with your favor. Help us, Lord, to look within us, Lord, search our hearts, that you cleanse us and cover us from all unrighteousness, so that we can come before you without any hindrance to worship you, Lord, without come boldly before your presence, Lord, to worship and to give you praise. Thank you, Lord, for this day. Thank you, Lord, for bringing us together in this house to worship you. Lord, commit the worship service from the beginning to the end into your hands. May you speak through your servant, Reverend Su, as he brings your word to us. Lord, commit each and every one here that, Lord, we will lift up our voices to sing praises to you, to give thanks to you. Lord, we thank you and praise you in Jesus' most precious name, we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Let us lift up our voices and worship our Almighty God and exalt his name.
让我们预备我们的同唱, 我敬拜你全能神,何等尊贵我主。
I worship you, O Prince.
是我的。
forward the time to Reverend Zhu and Brother Ali for the interpretation.
我们现在把时间交给朱牧师还有阿利弟兄的翻译。
We thank God for the opportunity to come before Him on such a beautiful Sunday morning to worship Him.
各位弟兄姊妹，平安。
Peace to you, brothers and sisters.
今天这段经文大家看到比较长哦，那我开因为时间的关系呢，我先只读一节经文，读这个最后一节了，37节啊。等一下前面的这段这些经文呢，我们会慢慢的来把它读的，来分析的啊。好。
Today's passage is quite long, so I'm just going to read one verse, the last one, 5:37, and then we will just touch on all the other verses.
主耶稣说，你们的话是就说是，不是就说不是，若再多说，就是出于那恶者。
Jesus said, "All you need to say is simply yes or no. Anything beyond this comes from the evil one."
今天这段经文我刚才已经说到了，是有点长。
As I mentioned, today's passage is quite lengthy.
这是因为按照是教会的年历所安排的一个主日的福音经文。
And we have this passage because it is according to the church traditional calendar.
当然我们的教会不是按照教会的年历来安排主日的经文。
But then our church does not strictly follow the church traditional calendar in presenting the sermons.
那今天的这个这段的教会的所安排的经文啊，是在显现期的，今天是第六个主日 ，Epiphany
number six.
Yeah.
According to the church traditional calendar, it is Epiphany number six.
什么叫显现期？就是主耶稣要显现来告诉我们。
And what's the meaning of this Epiphany? It means that Jesus appearing to us and instructing us.
那它是从第四个主日啊。一直到今天，显现期的主日，他都是引用的是马太福音，登山宝训，从第五章到第七章。
From the fourth Sunday to today, the verses used is from the Beatitudes, Matthew chapter 5-7.
Beatitudes 只是那个叫
Sermon on
the Mountain 对，那你讲的也。那其实呢，第四个主日是用了那个八福。
And it is a sermon on the mount, including the beatitudes.
是。然后呢，接下去上了主日的经文呢，他主耶稣是在讲，我们都很熟悉的讲，你们是世上的光，世上的盐。
And the passage previous to this, just before this, is Jesus telling us, "You are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world."
那主耶稣，你去看他的这登山宝训啊。
And if you look at Jesus' Sermon on the Mount,
他的主线围绕的是什么呢？就是讲悔改，就是在讲天国。
What is the message, the core message? It is about repentance, the kingdom of God.
什么叫悔改呢？就是你们过去的信仰啊，犹太人的信仰，对摩西的认识是不对的，现在要改变，这就是在这里要强调的悔改。
When Jesus talked about repentance, what does he mean? He was telling the Jewish people that The belief that you have what you have before it was wrong. You need to change that.
所以你等一下就会看到，从今天的这段经文啊，都是主耶稣要在改变犹太人的他们的信仰，他们宗教的信仰。
Then we will see in the passage that we have today how Jesus wanted the people to change their belief.
所以呢，今天我就跟大家愿意一起来分享一个主题是什么呢？就是要遵守主的话。
So that's how I came up with the topic for today. That is keeping the Lord's word.
因为讲到遵守主的话，我们常常会心里有一种困惑啊。
When we talk about keeping the Lord's words, we might wonder about this.
我们常常已经习惯于听，哎呀，我们现在是信了耶稣以后，难道我们还要遵守摩西的律法吗？
Because we have heard this teaching before. Once we believe in Jesus Christ, we are under grace. If we are under grace, then do we have to keep the laws of Moses?
这是我们的问题，所以我们要来看主耶稣怎么说的。
This is our understanding, and it is a problem. That is why today we are going to look at it.
好，下面让我们同祷告。
Now let us pray.
全能的主，我们所有的欲望你都晓得。主，我们知道在你面前没有可以隐藏的私密，求主打开我们的心门，借着宝贵是圣灵来接近我们的心思意念，以至于我们能够全然的爱你，领受你宝贵的话语。主，我们这样的如此祈求，乃是奉靠主耶稣基督的名求。
阿门。
好，今天的这篇正道是为了帮助或者提醒我们弟兄姊妹，我们要进一步的去认识主。
Today's message is to remind us and to help us to have a deeper understanding of our Lord Jesus Christ.
去认识主啊，他是如何在解释摩西的律法。
And we need to have a better understanding of the law of Moses, the way Jesus wanted us to understand.
同时呢，我们也要来查看我们自己在日常生活当中是否能够来遵守主耶稣的教训。
And then reflect on our daily lives, that whether we are able to keep the word of Jesus Christ in our daily life.
如果我们看这个马太福音五章的21-37之前啊，主耶稣怎么说的呢？
And if we look at the passage before Matthew chapter 5 verse 21.
那主耶稣很明确地告诉我们。
And here Jesus clearly said,
莫想我来要废掉律法和先知，我来不是要废掉，那是要成全。我实在告诉你们，就是到了天地都要废去，律法的一点一画也不能废去，都要成全。
In Matthew chapter 5 verse 17, Jesus said,Do not think that I have come to abolish the law of the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. I tell you the truth. Until heaven and earth disappear, not the smallest letter, not the least of a stroke of a pen will by any means disappear from the law until everything is accomplished.
所以我们看到主耶稣他来是要成就这样摩西的律法，不是要废掉，不是要改变。
So here we see what is Jesus' mission. He has come to fulfill the law. He has come not to abolish the law.
好，所以我们接下来我们就来学习，来体会主耶稣对摩西律法的解释。
And now let us look at how Jesus explained the law of Moses.
其实这一段经文，等一下大家会讲看到。主耶稣其实在解释摩西律法的三个方面。
And as Jesus explain the law of Moses, there are three areas.
第一个就是十诫里面的关于杀人的诫命。
And first, he did it from one of the Ten Commandments, that is, do not murder.
第二个，主耶稣在解释是关于淫乱。关于离婚的这个诫命。
And then the second area that he touched on is about marriage, the adultery.
第三个方面呢是在讲什么律法里面讲的不可以背誓不可以起誓。
And the third one he talked about is making vows, taking oaths.
好，我们来看这个第一个方面啊。
And now let's look at the first one, murder.
我们来读那个21节到26节啊。
We'll read from verse 21 to 26.
这个你不用翻译，大家就是下面看英文的，我是读中文的啊。你们听见有人吩咐古人的话说，不可杀人，又说凡杀人的难免受刑罚。只是我告诉你们。 凡有凡向弟兄动怒的，难免受审判；凡骂弟兄是拉架的，难免公会的审判；凡骂弟兄是魔力的，难免地狱的火。所以你们在祭坛前献礼物的时候，若想起弟兄向你怀的愿， 就把礼物留在坛前，先去同弟兄和好，然后再来献礼物。你同告的对头还在路上的时候，就赶紧去与他和谐，恐怕他把你送给审判官，审判官交付衙役，你就 下在监狱了。我实在告诉你，若有一文钱没有还清，你断不能从那里出来。好，各位弟兄姊妹，Dear
brothers and sisters，
这一段的话，你会发现主耶稣所讲的，他是在解释这关于杀人。
And here Jesus is talking about murder.
因为讲，我们大家都知道十诫讲的杀人，我们并不觉得自己会杀人。And
the murder, as in Ten Commandment, when people talk about it, everyone would say we do not murder people.
我们觉得，这一段经文，主耶稣只是在讲要跟弟兄和好。 不管是我得罪了别人，还是得罪了我们，我们要去跟他和解。And
when we read this verse, we'll only pay attention to that part about living in peace with everyone, that we don't fight with anyone.
但是你会发现，耶稣恰恰是用关于你与人不能和解，无论是别人的错还是你的错。 他跟什么诫命连在一起啊？杀人。
But then here you see that when Jesus talk about living in peace, he mentioned something about whether it is you are in the right or not. It is all to do with murder.
我们在日常生活当中，我们似乎几乎是每天都会发生什么呢？我们讲了，就是。 口角就是我们跟家里亲人也好，教会里的弟兄姊妹也好，在社会上也好，都会发生一些争吵争论，有不同的意见。And
I'm sure in our daily lives, each and every day, we are bound to have disagreement, whether it be at our workplace with family members or among friends, there are going to be verbal fights.
因为我们这个都知道。 人的舌头啊，是个祸害，可以成为地狱的之火，可以去杀人的。这是在雅各书，大家都熟悉的。And
we all know that the tongue, it can create a lot of evil. Actually, it says it is like the hell, fire from hell.
它是可以杀人的。And
that tongue can kill people.
那我们。 有时候可能也听到过，因为某个人一句话，他就会影响别人一生。
And we have heard that because someone said something, just a word, and it affected someone else his whole life.
可能使别人一辈子不信主。
Maybe because of something someone said, the other person never believed in the Lord.
但是我们并不觉得这是属于杀人。
But then when we think about this action, we do not think that it is murder.
当别人来伤害我们的时候，
But then when someone do something wrong with us,
比如说人家不信主的人来伤害我的话，如果我不饶恕别人的话，
And especially the non-believer, if they have hurt us, and then I have to forgive them.
你会发现你在伤害自己，你在杀害自己。
And then you'll feel that you are hurting inside.
我们常常不会把这个连在一起去这么想啊。
And then we do not connect these together.
你知道现在这个社会啊，什么样的问题越来越多了？就是忧郁症越来越多。
And then you'll find that in today's society, there is something that is going on that you find that very prevalent. That is depression.
你知道所谓的心理学家、心理咨询者，他在帮你找着各种各样的理由啊，帮你找出这个问题的核心啊。他从来不知道是你常常所造成的这种所谓的心理问题啊，就是你自己对自己的伤害。
And then when these psychologists and then psychiatrists talk about these problems, they never said that the problem is within yourself. You are hurting yourself.
在社会上的这种心理学者，他不会把基督的信仰跟你联系起来，他也不会把主耶稣的教训去帮助别人。
And then all these psychiatrists, they are not going to delve into the teaching of Lord Jesus Christ or from the Bible, saying that this is where the problem is.
那在教会里呢？其实呢，大家呢也不，因为觉得你受伤害了呢，就是其实用世俗的一种方法来帮助这些自己所谓觉得受伤的人。
And even in the church, when you talk about hurting inside, we find that we try to use a method used by this medical world.
如果你告诉他你有问题，你要到主面前来，要认识自己。
And then if you said that you have a problem and you want to come before the Lord and repent and admit you are wrong.
他会confuse 的，他会混乱的。
Then that person would not know what to say, is all confused.
因为在社会上，人家跟他讲的都是来安慰他、帮助他，让他寻找自我，可以得到一种满足，得到一种平安喜乐。
And because whatever that person heard is all about himself, it is all about discovering who he really is.
但是你说要你认识你自己，是你在伤害自己，是要靠主耶稣来医治的时候，他不听的，他走了。
But to discover ourselves that we are hurting ourselves, we need to heal ourselves. They just cannot accept that.
这也是这几年当中我碰到很多的这些案例啊。
And this is what I found from case studies over the recent years.
那么我们要来，还是要回到耶稣怎么来解释的？
And now let us look at how Jesus explained the thing.
现在社会上有各种各样的解释，
And
不是讲是这个就讲人的问题，我们讲是灵里的问题，他们是在讲心理的问题，讲一种精神的问题。
And then you'll find that people in this world talk about these problems as a mental health.
耶稣在讲到这个杀人啊，跟你能不能人家伤害你，你要去饶恕别人；自己伤害别人是要向别人道歉的时候，主耶稣有明确的教训。
And you find that when Jesus talked about murder, he linked it to, if someone hurts you, you need to forgive that person. If you have hurt someone, you need to ask for forgiveness.
主耶稣永远要让我们去面对上帝。
And what Jesus is saying is that whatever we do, we have to face God over our action.
我们永远要面对神的诫命。
And whatever we do, we have to see it in the light of God's commandment.
我们永远要去遵守主的诫命。
And the truth is, we have to keep the commandments of God.
所以耶稣，我这里再次强调的， 耶稣说我不是来废掉，我是要来成全摩西的律法。
So I repeat what Jesus said. He said, I have come to fulfill the law. I have come not to abolish the law.
所以耶稣 在马太福音18章23到35节也讲了个比喻，大家也很熟悉的。
And so Jesus in Matthew chapter 18 verse 20-13, he said this.
你看，我刚才讲的是耶稣在讲道，他总是一条线，一个是在讲天国，一个是要讲悔改。
And I have mentioned before, when Jesus began his instruction, he talks about repentance on one hand and then the kingdom of God on the other hand.
如果你要理解主耶稣讲的这个关于不可杀人的，他又联系到人的要饶恕别人，这样的一个教训的话，你要就是要来看他在马太福音18章的怎么样的解释。
And then when you want to understand how Jesus talked about murder, at the same time talking about doing wrong to other people and asking for forgiveness, then we have to look at it in the light of Matthew chapter 18.
所以主耶稣讲得很清楚，开始的时候他就讲了，天国就好像是一个王要和他的仆人算账。
And this is a parable about Jesus saying that the kingdom of God is like a master settling his account with his servant.
我们也常常只会想到将来的审判。
We always think about the judgment in the future.
等主耶稣来的时候的审判。
When Jesus returned, then there is judgment.
其实你仔细来，这段故事大家都很熟悉的。
And then if we look at this parable, we are all familiar with it.
你今天要把它跟关于杀人的这个解释连起来，你自己回去好好的学习。
And if you connect it with Jesus' commandment about murder, then we have something to learn here.
所以主耶稣就讲了一个比喻。
And this is Jesus' parable.
有一个人啊，他欠了那个主人的是一千两银子。
And then he said there was a servant, he owed his master 1,000 talent.
但是他没有办法去偿还嘛。
So he has no means of repaying that debt.
所以他要把他的妻子儿女所有的一切包括他家产都要去卖掉来偿还。
So he sold everything he has, his house, even his wife and children.
然后他就到这个 主人面前来说，主啊，宽容我，将来我都要还清。
And then he come before his master and say, woe to me, I want to repay my debt.
那仆人的主人就动了慈心，把他释放了，免了他的债。
And then you find that the master is touched, so the master forgive all his debt.
那这个仆人大家都知道，他遇见有一个同伴欠他只有10两银子。
But then this man, after his debt were forgiven, he went out and then he saw a man who owed him 10 talents.
说便求助他，掐住他的喉咙说，你把所欠的还给我。
And then this man caught the other person by the throat and said, you need to repay me my debt.
他的同伴就俯伏央求他说，宽容我吧。 将来我必还清。
And then his friend said, have mercy on me, give me some time, I will repay that debt.
他不肯，竟把他送到监狱里去，等他还清了所有的债。
But this man was not willing to listen. So he took him to the law and then put him in the prison.
那有人就去把这件事情告诉了主人了。And
then someone told this to his master.
那主人听到了以后就把这个人叫来了。And
then the master sent for the servant.
他说你是这个恶奴才，你央求我，我就把你所欠的免了你。你不应当连续你的同伴，向我连续你吗？
And then the master said, "You are the evil one. When you beg of me to forgive you, I forgive you. But then, when it is your turn to forgive other people, you did not forgive."
所以主人就大怒，把他交给掌刑了，等他还清了所有的债。So
the master was angry and sent him to the prison.
所以你们个人若不从心里饶恕， 你的弟兄，我天父也要这样待你们。
And then Jesus said, "If you do not forgive your brother, then my Father in heaven will treat you the same way."
如果你很，大家都很会，都会背的主导文。如果在主导文，在马太，福音第六章，耶稣特别关于饶恕，他有同样的解释。
And we all can say the Lord's Prayer from memory. And if we remember, even in, we can find it in the book of Matthew, this is what Jesus said.
各位弟兄姊妹，你有没有想到过，我每天要遵守什么，不要杀人这样的诫命？
And has it ever occurred to us that we need to really keep this commandment, that is, do not murder?
你有没有每天在晚上去祷告的时候，讲到我今天伤害了多少人，我明天要去跟他人家什么叫饶恕别人，别人伤害了我的时候，我怎么求主来赐给我一个饶恕的心？
And at the end of every day when we pray, do we ever reflect on how many people we have hurt, and we think about connected with this commandment, do not murder?
各位弟兄姊妹，我们每天晚上可能会祷告，有的人甚至祷告都不祷告。你祷告的时候，是你怎样祷告的时候？
And every at the end of every day, do we pray? And if we pray, how do we pray?
你有没有检查自己在遵守主耶稣的教训？
Do we ever examine ourselves to see whether we have obeyed the commandments of Jesus?
耶稣不是来废掉摩西的律法跟先知的道理，他是来成全。什么叫成全？他就告诉你，你怎样在每天的生活当中可以去遵守的。Remember,
Jesus said he has come not to abolish the law, but to fulfill the law. That is how we can keep the law.
好，我们 这个问题留给大家，大家每天晚上你去自己去祷告啊。And
I will leave this question with you. You think about it.
那么我们再往下看。And
then we look at the next one.
下面是27到32啊。And
the next portion is from 27 to 32.
他这里怎么说？我们来，我还是我来读一下啊。
The verses will be read out to you in Chinese.
你们听见有话说，不可奸淫。只是我告诉你们，凡看见妇人就动淫念的，就心里已经与她犯了奸淫。若你们眼睛叫你跌倒，就弯出来丢掉，宁可失去白体中一体， 不叫全身丢在地狱里，若是眼睛叫你跌倒，就砍下来丢掉，宁可失去白体中的一个一体，不能叫他入地狱。看到啊，不能叫他入地狱。又有话说，人若休妻，就给他休书。只是我告诉你，凡休妻的，若不是为淫乱的缘故， 就是叫她做淫妇。人若娶这被休的妇人，也是犯 坚硬了。各位弟兄姊妹，这一段话我们听到主耶稣讲话是很严厉很严厉的。
And dear brothers and sisters, you will look at how Jesus is so serious about this topic.
我们一般来说呢，我们千万不只要只是从文字上，哦，我真的把眼睛挖掉啊，把眼睛挖。
We should never go literally on this that we take out our own eyes.
耶稣在这里让我们是要来恨恶我们自己，我们不愿意把。他让主来对付的这种罪。
And what Jesus meant is that Jesus does not allow the fact that we hate the fact we do not allow Jesus to deal with our sin.
我们平心的想啊，我们如果得了病，
And just think about this, if we are sick,
我们得了病的话，我们能够不开刀就不开刀。
Because especially talking about surgery,Every one of us try to avoid surgery.
哪怕得了癌症，你觉得最好是不要开刀，不要做手术。
Even if you have cancer, you don't want to go through surgery or chemo.
有其他的方法都可以解决，最后不行才是开刀。
And try to do it some other way, and the last resort is surgery.
这是我说，我们看到我们每个人都是这样的，是吧？很正常的。
This is what I feel, what I see in every one of us.
那我们这方面的话，我还是来让我们注重在主耶稣讲的关于不可奸淫，不可以离婚，不可以休妻。
And I want to touch on what Jesus said that do not commit adultery and there should not be divorce.
这个把它连在一起啊。
And then we connect these two together.
那我们来看当今的社会，这个离婚率啊。
We look at today's society and the rate of divorce.
我们可以听到周围有许许多多的人离婚。
And we know that there are so many people around us, they have gone through divorce.
甚至呢，那个在教会里这样的情况也是很多的。
And even in the church, you find that there are many cases like this.
所以，关于淫乱也好，奸淫也好，离婚也好，似乎不是成为一个道德的问题。
And whether it be adultery or divorce, it is no longer a question of ethics.
人家不觉得离婚或者犯奸淫是一个羞耻的一个罪。
And then.In today's society, there's no shame attached to adultery or divorce.
我们无论是在北美还是在中国大陆啊，
whether it be in North America or in mainland China,
我不太了解台湾啊跟香港跟印度啊到底什么样的情况，可能差不多吧。
I do not have much understanding about India, Taiwan.Or other places, but I think it is more or less the same.
邱牧师在亚特可能好一点情况啊，没有，哦，好，印度是很好，还可以比较好啊。好，我们来看，我们看我们周围的，香港、台湾我不知道，香港不知道怎么样现在啊。
And I don't know about Hong Kong, Taiwan.
那我所看到的，但是至少我周围所接触的还有。那从在这里啊，加拿大来说，他们讲到那些从中国大陆来的这个，还有包括在中国，离婚啊，每年离婚啊比结婚的人数还要多，很可怕的哦。
And I have heard this that people from mainland China in North America or even in China, the mainland China.That each year the people getting divorced is more than the people getting married.
如果我们说离婚啊，婚外情啊，这些都是犯淫乱的罪。
And if we say that divorce or extramarital affairs are all adultery,
我不知道我们自己周围的年轻人或者我们家里的年轻人啊。印度不说，我们这小孩子在这里成长的，他们会有怎么样的反应呢？
I wonder the young people, whether it be in church or in a family member, what will they think of this?
我刚才不是在讲印度，我们在讲这里孩子成长起来了啊。
We are talking about people right here.
我相信小孩子啦，他有时候不见得在反对你，他可能心里会怎么说呢？哎呀，你们都是老人家啦，你们太古板啦，太落后啦。And
I'm sure the young people might not say it loud, but they might think in their heart, you guys are so old-fashioned. You are not modern.
如果他们会要想离婚，或者是有第三者的。 婚外情，他们可能第一个跟你家里人不说
，and because if there is a divorce or extramarital affair, they might not even mention it.
跟你家里人有隔阂
，and there is a gap between family members.
甚至在教会里，他不来教会了
，or that person might just stop coming to church.
这是很现实的
，this is what's happening.
对我们现在的，我们都有孩子的啊，我们现在。 教会很重视孩子，我觉得很好。我们去应该是知道现在的这样的北美的风气是很邪恶的。And
especially those who have the families who have children, you'll find that this is what's going on in the society.
那么，我们是要遵守主耶稣的心意呢，还是要去体贴人的心意？
Are we going to obey the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, or are we going to follow our physical needs?
难道教会也要去随着社会的变化，我们来看看我们怎么调整，可不可以？
And is it for the church to adjust our beliefs according to what's happening in the world?
我看到有的很多的教会啊。 他因为希望这些教会弟兄姊妹不离开教会，所以他们呢就想些办法去说，其实叫不痛不痒的去说了。And
then you find that many churches just to retain the membership might not even talk about these things.
我们还以为是以爱的缘故。
And then some will even say that actually we are doing this out of love.
我们爱他们嘛。
Because we love those people.
我们慢慢谈嘛。
And then we just talk about it, doing it slowly.
我们来转变他们嘛。
And we try to change them.
你觉得会有效吗？ 我只是把这个问题放在大家，问大家啊。
Do you think it will be effective? I just want to throw this question out.
那这是一个现实的社会问题。
This is a practical problem in a society.
我们还是要回到主耶稣。 基督里来看，让主耶稣怎样教导的，来我们来反省，来面对这样的社会问题。我们知道，我们个人也好，教会也好，应当怎样处理。And
let us come back to the teachings of our Lord Jesus Christ and see what the Lord instructs us to do.
好，我还是用主耶稣自己的话语来解释主耶稣的话语，那是在马太福音19章。
And we'll still use the word of our Lord Jesus Christ. This time it is from Matthew chapter 19.
但是3到第9节啊。That
is 3 to 9, verse 3 to 9.
在学习这个之前，各位弟兄姊妇，你先有一个想象，去认识到，其实关于离婚不离婚的事情啊，其实几千年来一直存在的。 就是在摩西在发布这个律法之前啊，都已经存在了。And
then when we talk about the problem of divorce, to divorce or not to divorce, you find that this problem has been there for thousands of years, even from the time of Moses.
所以你看啊，就是在主耶稣那个时代，法利赛人他们也面对这样的一个社会问题，他们来问耶稣了。其实他们来挑战耶稣。And
even during the time of Jesus Christ, some people use this question to challenge Jesus.
你看，有法利赛人他们来试探耶稣。
And then some Pharisee came to test Jesus.
他们怎么说？人无论什么样的缘故，什么样的缘故，他可以休妻吗？就是他可以离婚吗？
The question they ask Jesus is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any and every reason?
那耶稣很简单地告诉他们, 从创世纪来看,
and then this is how Jesus replied. He started from the Genesis.
那起初造人是造男造女, 并且说, 因此人要离开父母, 与妻子联合, 二人成为一体。
And Jesus said, haven't you read that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female and said, for this reason a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife and the two will become one flesh.
耶稣把这个问题丢给他们了。
And then Jesus replied with a question.
答案就在摩西的律法, 就在创世纪开始的时候就这么说了。
The answer is in the law and it is in the book of Genesis.
所以他说既然如此,
and Jesus said, since it is like this,
夫妻不再是两个人, 乃是一体, 所以上帝配合的, 人不能分开。
So he said, the husband and wife are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate.
Yeah, 耶稣讲没有任何理由的。
There is no reason.
法利赛人开始的就问他, 有什么样的缘故可以离婚不离婚?
And the question asked by the Pharisee was for any or every reason.
那法利赛人继续来说了。
And then the Pharisee continued.
那么摩西为什么吩咐给妻子休书呢? 就可以休他呢?
They asked, why then did Moses command that a man give his wife a certificate of divorce and send her away?
如果我们去看摩西的律法，我们看到是有这样的记载的。
If you go through the laws of Moses, you will find this is indeed there.
那耶稣来讲到关于这个这一点了，对摩西的律法做了解释了，关于婚姻来做解释了。And then
Jesus replied and made an explanation.
讲的讲是摩西啊，其实在讲耶和华上帝啊。耶稣怎么说？摩西因为你们心刚硬，所以给允许你们休妻，但 起初不是这样的，我一直读完啊。我告诉你们，凡休妻另娶的，若不是为淫乱的缘故，他就犯奸淫罪。有人娶那被休的妇人，也犯奸淫了。And
Jesus replied, Jesus said, Moses, but actually we can treat it as God said. Moses permitted you to divorce your wives because your hearts were hard. But it was not this way from the beginning. I tell you that anyone who divorces his wife, except for marital unfaithfulness, and marry another woman commits adultery.
我们一定要搞清楚，有一个字上面少，要很清晰地认识到。
And we need to be very clear on this.
允许一下，不等于是赞同。
Permit does not mean that allow
or agree with
or agree.
Yeah, allow 的就是他可以允许，但不是 agree, 他同意，他赞成。
Permit does not mean agree to.
所以我们常常把这个混乱了。
Very often we confuse these two.
你看哦，我举个例子啊，当犹太人他们自己跟撒母耳吵。 他们也要自己的皇，上帝允许吧？上帝允许，上帝还跟他们去找王了。And
for an example,
让我再把这个讲完。而且他们耶稣耶和华上帝明明知道他们不要耶和华上帝来做王，让耶和华上帝，你们要这样，你们自己去看结果。And
for an example, the people of Israel wanted a king. Was it there in God's will? Actually, it is not, but God permitted it. But then God even helped them to look for a king.
所以这是很显，我们不用去争的，不用去人的各种各样的方式去解释的，不要因为社会现在怎么样，我们想尽要符合社会的，我们去绞尽脑汁去解释，都我们这样去解释，我们在违背主义的教训。
And we do not have to fight over this, that there are things that we do, we might think that it is permitted by God, but actually it is not in God's will.
好，我们讲时间哇，过得很快，我们讲解释最后一段时间，我有一点解释啊。
And then because of the time, we come to the last part.
从33到37
Reading from verse 33 to 37.
你们又听见有 古人吩咐说, 不可背时, 所起的事, 总要向主遵守, 只是我告诉你们, 什么事都不可起, 不可指着天起时, 因为天是上帝的座右, 不可指着地起时, 因为地是他的脚灯, 也不可指着耶路撒冷起时, 因为耶路撒冷是大军的, 精诚又不可以指着你的头发起誓，因为你不能使一根头发变白，变黑变白。好，这句话后面最重要。你们的话是就说是，不是就说不是。若再多说，就是出于那恶者。好，因为我刚才已经讲，我只是都你不用再多。好，耶稣在这一段关于 启示的话，其实人常常觉得人家不相信我的话嘛，然后我们就我可以发中国人常常我可以发天启，向天发誓，我讲的话是真的，有没有听到过？小时候小孩子常常会这样啊。We
take oaths, make vows because we feel that some people do not believe what we say.
其实这里面你知道有一个很大的问题在哪里？
But you find that there is a big problem here.
我们常常以为自己是诚实的。
Because very often we feel that we are being very honest.
其实圣经告诉我, 人心比万物都诡诈。
But actually the Bible said a person's heart is much more evil. It is more evil than anything else.
我们从来不愿意接受自己会说谎话的人。We
never admit to the fact that we will lie.
那现在的人觉得说谎谎言呢，哎呀，也是没有啊，人人都说谎啊，说谎有什么？最多是个缺点错误嘛。And
you would find that in today's society, everyone does not take lying seriously because everyone does it. It is just a way of life.
你想记得美国总统啊，他们两个人在竞争的时候，互相都是骂对方是 liar，是不是？And
especially you see that in U.S. presidential election, both the candidates calling each other a liar.
那 liar，他说他 liar，他也说 liar，大家下面呢，你们都是 liar，其实大家觉得无所谓，但 liar这个社会就是 liar的。So
everyone is lying, so it's not a big deal.
现在甚至你看到科学也在 liar。
And then even in the science, you find that you don't have all the facts.
所以他们来一切都是有利益，有各种各样的利益，无论是为权力的意义，为经济的利益，他背后总归是为了达到自己的目的。And
you find that everyone lies because they want to get what they want, whether it be for money or anything else.
那耶稣在这里明确地告诉 你们不要发誓，因为你们要知道什么？你要认识到自己是什么？你们是来的人，你们会犯罪的，你们会说谎的。And
here Jesus said, "You should not take oath. Why? Because you will lie all the time."
所以耶稣说：“你们的话是就说，是不是就说不是。再若多说，就是出于那恶者，恶者就是出于魔鬼。”That's
why Jesus said, "Simply yet let your yes be yes." Your no, no, for anything beyond this comes from the evil one.
我总是也希望大家从圣经上去看，你去看马太福音23章。
I want us to always look at these in the light of the Bible, especially now let's look at Matthew chapter 23.
主耶稣，这是马太福音23章的16到22节啊。
from reading from verse 16 to 22.
因为时间的关系，我不把它整个读下来，大家回去好好的学习。
And because of time, I will not read it, but we can look at it at home.
主耶稣讲我们说谎啊，他是这里讲的，他反复的强调的是什么呢？是瞎子，眼瞎的人。
And when Jesus talked about lying, he connected with a person who is blind.
所以耶稣说，从二十三节这里，大家回去可以说，你们这瞎眼领路的人有祸了。
He said, those who are blind, woe to you.
到接下去到十七节，你们这无知瞎眼的人，什么是大的？问问题了。
And then he said, you who know so little, and you are evil, what is wrong with you?
到十九节又说，你们这瞎眼的人，什么是大的？是礼物还是叫礼物成圣的坛呢？
And then he talked about you being liar, the blind one, what is gift? You don't know.
各位弟兄姊妹，这里讲的不是讲我们肉眼的瞎眼。
And here, when Jesus talked about blindness, it is not physically blind.
耶稣在这里强调是我们灵里的瞎眼。
Jesus is talking about spiritual blindness.
各位弟兄姊妹，你有没有想到过，当你在说谎的时候，你是个瞎眼的，你是灵里是瞎眼的？
Do you ever realize that when you lie, you are showing that you are spiritually blind?
当你是瞎眼的时候，你跟上帝是没有关系的。
And when you are spiritual blind, you have no connection with God.
我们常常是活在一个自欺的光景当中。
And we live in this self-deceiving world.
我们觉得我们这个社会上没人在说谎，如果我不说谎，我就没有办法生活下去了。
And then we feel that we are living in this world when everyone is lying. If I don't lie along with others, then how do I live my life?
我们常常把这个罪恶去掩盖起来。
And very often we just cover up our sin.
我们从来没有讲到过我们要圣洁。
And it never occurs to us that God calls us to be holy.
我们没有想到过我们怎样应该去靠着主，靠着圣灵来帮助我，能够像主耶稣基督那样。
And we never thought about with the help of Jesus and Holy Spirit, we can be more like Him.
所以，使徒约翰
，So Apostle John.
我相信当时他在听的时候，他也不见得一定能够完全的，接受或认同。
And I'm sure he could not fully understand and accept what Jesus was saying.
但是他后来又听到主耶稣这样去描写的话，是在后来他记载他的约翰福音书中，在第八章的时候提到了。
And then later on when he was writing St. John chapter 8, this is what he said.
为什么主耶稣就把那跟恶者说谎啊，跟恶者跟魔鬼连在一起的？
Why Jesus connect lying with the evil one, Satan?
我也是读一下啊，读一下。那如果你有圣经，你可以翻到那个43到47啊，我们时间的关系啊，我等一下把重点再读，可以。你们为什么不明白我说的话呢？无非是你们。 无非是因你们不能听我的话，不听我的道，你们是出于哪？你们的父魔鬼，你们父的私欲，你们偏要行，他是指魔鬼。从起初是杀人的，不遵守真理的，因他心里没有真理，他说谎是出于自己，因他本来是说谎的，也是说谎之人的父。 我将真理告诉你们，你们就因此不信我。你们中间谁能指着我有罪呢？我既然将真理告诉你们，为什么不信我呢？出于上帝的必听上帝的话，你们不听，因为你们不出于上帝。好，各位弟兄姊妹，这是耶稣的话。你看讲起来都是很严厉的。
And then Jesus was asking those who are listening to him, how come you do not listen to me? Why? Because you listen to the father of lies, the Satan.
真理就是主耶稣自己。
The truth is Jesus Christ.
所以耶稣跟他们讲的话就是真理。
And so whatever Jesus said is the truth.
主耶稣在今天讲的在马太福音这个 登山宝训里面在解释摩西律法的话，它就是真理。
And what Jesus taught us today from Mount Sermon on the Mount, the Beatitudes, they are the truth.
Mountain of the Sermon of the Mountain, 不是 Beatitudes，没关系，就是在你看到主耶稣的话语，他讲得很严，就是要去遵守的。你们听我的话，你们来遵守我的话语。
And Jesus just asks us to obey his words.
所以各位弟兄姊妹,
Dear brothers and sisters,
我们今天听到主耶稣自己在解释摩西的律法。
We have heard Jesus how he explained the law of Moses.
在马太福音, 在他的登山宝训, Mount of the Sermon.
In this passage from Matthew and from Sermon on the Mount.
然后我今天刚才给大家引了这些经文，看了很多，但是你看到都是主耶稣自己在其他不同的场合来解释关于杀人、关于淫乱、关于怎么样是在上帝的面前要诚实，在人面前要诚实，所以这些教训。
And we have seen from different passages how Jesus talked about we should not murder, there should not be adultery, and we should be honest and keep our words.
我们要，这要接下去我们要祷告。
This is why we need to pray.
我们要祷告是祷告什么呢？
And what do we need to pray about?
我们要为每个人要为自己祷告。
We pray for our own self.
我们要来遵守主耶稣的话。
We will keep the words of our Lord Jesus Christ.
你看，整本圣经啊，当中是什么呢？是诗篇。诗篇里面最长的是诗篇十九篇。诗篇第十九篇开始的一些经文就是：行为完全、遵守耶和华的律法的人，这人变为有福。
And you find that in the Bible, the longest book is in Psalm and. Psalm 119, and it says, Blessed is the man who is upright and keep the word of Lord.
各位弟兄姊妹,
Dear brothers and sisters,
你们愿不愿意成为一个有福的人?
Do you want to be blessed by God?
你们愿不愿意来遵守主耶稣的话?
Are you willing to obey the word of our Lord Jesus Christ?
盼望我们回去每天要为自己的好好的祷告，祷告再祷告。
And let us pray for our own self. Keep praying for ourselves.
在这个我们这混乱的社会当中，
In this world in turmoil,
没有道德底线的社会里面，
Where there is no longer any ethics,
主耶稣的话， 永不改变。
You find that the word of Jesus Christ never changes.
因为耶稣说天地都要改变，他的话一点一话都不改变。
Because Jesus said the heaven and earth will pass away, but his word, not a stroke, will pass away.
我巴不得我们每个人都来盼望，来愿意遵守主的命令。
Let each one of us be willing to obey the word of our Lord Jesus Christ.
我还是要挑战我们在家里的弟兄姊妹。
Finally, I want to challenge those brothers and sisters who are with us online.
除非你特殊原因。
Only if you have some very special circumstances.
身体的原因。
Some physical problem.
你没有理由不来这里来敬拜主。
There is no reason for you not to come to our church to worship together.
新冠病毒已经渐渐地远离了我们。You
find that this COVID pandemic is slowly passing away.
我们怕病毒，我们还是害怕上帝，就是要敬畏的啊。And
what are we more afraid of? Are we afraid of the pandemic or are we afraid of our God?
不要去听人的解释。We
should not listen to the explanation of the people.
听主的话语。
Let us listen to the word of God.
遵守主的教训,
and we keep the word of God.
下个主日, 从你躲在家里害怕得病的到这里来，主会祝福你的。
For next Sunday, those who are afraid of pandemic should come to church and God will bless you.
求主怜悯我们。
May the Lord have mercy on us.
让我们祝福，让我们一起祷告。
Let us pray.
主，摩西的律法是你自己制定的，主，摩西的律法也唯有你的解释是完全完整的。主，我们今天来到你的面前，我们只听你的解释。求主来帮助我们，求圣灵来激励我们，赐给我们有从你圣灵来的能力，有勇气，有信心。我们在日常的生活当中，在点点滴滴当中来遵守主你自己的命令。主，我们巴不得我们自己不要惧怕，不再听从世上的谎言。我们主日来到教会，所以我们查看我们自己，我们平时到什么地方都出去，我们去买东西，我们去吃饭，为什么我们不愿意来到主日，来到你的殿中来敬拜？这是我们的罪，求主赦免，让我们能够不再继续犯这同样的罪，让我们来到你的面前，让你的心意得到满足，让我们蒙你要赐给我们更大的祝福。谢谢主，我们这样的祈求感谢的是奉靠主耶稣基督的名求，
阿们。
Thank you, Reverend Su, for the message. Thank you, Brother Ali, for interpreting.
谢谢朱牧师的证道，还有阿里弟兄的翻译。
Now, in response, let's all sing. Thank you, thanks to God.
让我们来唱回应的诗歌，感谢神。
The scripture of the week taken from Isaiah 43 verse 19.
我们现在来念本周的经句，是在以赛亚书43章19节。
It says, "See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland."
看哪，我要做一件新事，如今要发现，你们岂不知道吗？我必在旷野开道路，在沙漠开江河。
Now is the time for a welcome and announcement. We welcome all brothers and sisters seated here, also joining us online.
现在是欢迎跟报告的时间，我们欢迎在座的弟兄姐妹，还有在线上的弟兄姐妹。
We would like to invite brothers and sisters to join our Sunday worship service in person at the church office every Sunday at 10:30 a.m. And the said service is also streamed live online. Prayer meetings on Tuesday at 8 p.m. and Children's Sunday School on Sunday at 9:30 a.m. are conducted online to Zoom. Everyone is welcome to join.
曾经邀请弟兄姐妹实体参加每周日的上午十点三十分在教会办公室举行的主日崇拜，然后崇拜也是同时在线上直播。此外，晚上八点钟的祷告会，主日上午九点三十分的儿童主日学将会以晚上 Zoom 的形式举行，欢迎弟兄姐妹参加。
And our church will be holding a revival meetings in Feb. That means in the coming week. Reverend Petros Chan, the ex-president of Ling Liang Worldwide, will be the special speaker. The theme is Transform Lives. The schedule of the meetings are as follows. Actually, it's coming Friday, February 17 at 7:30 p.m. And the theme is Be the Salt. And coming Saturday, February 18 at 7:30 p.m., the theme is Be the Light. And Sunday, February 19, worship service at 10:30 a.m., the theme is Be the Witness. Also, there will be a potluck for the Saturday evening at 6 p.m., just before the meeting. Please register with Mrs. Chen, and today is the last day to register. Invite everyone to please pray for and attend the meetings.
教会将会举办培灵会，然后讲员是陈静茹牧师，前年会的会长。 主题是改变生命，日期是在2月17号下个礼拜五晚上的7点30分，主题是坐言，然后2月18号星期六晚上7点半，主题是坐光，2月19号星期日主日崇拜，上午10点半的主题是坐见证，而星期六在培灵会之前晚上的6点钟，我们有 potluck 的聚餐。 请向陈李慧华姐妹报名，邀请弟兄姐妹踊跃参加，并在祷告中纪念。
There's a couple of special announcements.
现在有几项的特别的报告。So
please take note. The first one is our church is requesting brothers and sisters to support an Afghan woman who has believed in the Lord to subsidize her family to buy food every month. We will be subsidizing her for 5 months. It's about $200 per month, and later her family will be able to receive government assistance. If you are touched by the Lord, please give the cash to Angela or myself. This is done individually and not through the church, so we do not accept e-transfers. Please note that there will be no tax receipts also for this donation. For more details, you can inquire with Pastor Chen.
然后教会现在会向一位已经信主的阿富汗的姐妹资助她的家庭购物每月的粮食的需要，我们将会资助她5个月，每个月大概200块，然后她的5个月以后他们将会得到政府的资助，如果你有感动的话，可以把现金交给我或是郑弟兄。 然后这是一个特殊的个案，所以我们是不经过教会的银行的，所以我们不会接受电子的转账，然后如果说也不会得到教会的那个免费的收条，如果想了解更多的详情的话，可以跟陈传道联络。And
the second announcement is beloved sister Mrs. Hu has been promoted to glory this morning. So please keep the family in your prayers.
然后我们很我们的亲爱的胡姐妹，她今天早上已经主怀安息，然后让我们在祷告中纪念她的家人。Let's
all stand as we sing the doxology and request Pastor to give the benediction.
请大家一同起立，我们唱三一颂，然后牧师祝福。
God shall all blessing mean, trees and all nature's
继续站立，让我们接受主的祝福，但愿主耶稣基督的恩惠、父神的大爱、圣灵的教众也感动，常与众弟兄姊妹们同在，从今直到永永远远。阿门。Shall we receive God's benediction? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, fellowship and the communion of God the Holy Spirit be with us now.And forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Have a safe and blessed week, and see you next Sunday.
各位请坐，末祷后散会。